Welcome back to the show. Well, breast cancer is a huge issue in Australia, with 15,000 women diagnosed this year alone. 31-year-old mum of two, Verity Smith, is facing a very rare and aggressive form of the disease that has left her fighting for her life. Studio 10 reporter David Robertson is outside Verity's house this morning. David, Verity has no idea you're outside her home right now, does she?
She certainly doesn't, Sarah Harris. We're coming to you live this morning from the beautiful Adelaide Hills in South Australia, where we are going to give Verity quite the surprise of her life, and we give her some pretty big gifts live on air this morning. Now, as you mentioned, Verity and her family have been dealt quite a tragic blow this year, but by all accounts, she is a fighter and she is battling this disease with all her strength. And I found this out when I spent a bit of time with her partner, Aaron, and her beautiful mum, Jeanette. Have a look.
The love that Verity and Aaron share is as true as it comes.
She's the most intelligent, beautiful lady I've ever met in my life. She's caring, she's got a massive heart, she'll do anything for anyone. She lights up a room when she comes in.
When you hear Aaron talking about his fiancée, it could make even the hardest of hearts believe in soulmates. So it came as no surprise that on Christmas Day 2008, Aaron asked Verity to be his wife.
I had a ring organised, had already worked out her size, wrapped it in a big ball, that's so big, then rolled along the table and said, I got a present for you, I'm going outside for a minute.
I think that's awesome.
That was pretty much it.
I think that's awesome.
She started crying and then she said, stop being piss weak and get down here and put your knee on the ground, and I just said, I'll do a hammy if I do that. She pretty much just pointed to the ground and I said, I did it properly.
Yeah.
Mind you, absolutely shitting myself at the same time.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, she said yes.
And the happy times continued for this young couple. Less than a year later, their dream of starting a family became a reality with the birth of their first child, Austin. And shortly after, he was joined by Riley. For a few years, life was typical and rewarding for this young family living in the Adelaide Hills. But early this year, that started to change. Verity began to experience pain, including a sharp stabbing sensation in her chest. Initially, she didn't tell Aaron, a way of protecting the man that she loved. But it soon became too much.
Oh, it made me feel, quite upset, quite sad. You know, someone that you love's in so much pain, you don't know what it is, and she doesn't know what it is.
Over the next couple of weeks, they saw two doctors. Both said that she was pushing herself too hard and needed to relax. But that didn't sit well with either of them. Deep down, they both knew that it was far more serious. And after a visit to a third doctor and urgent scans, their worst fears were confirmed. Verity was diagnosed with secondary breast cancer.
And she said that it spread to other organs, and I said, where? And she said it started on her left side under her left armpit, covered her entire left breast, spread all the way across to her right-hand side, started going up the right-hand side of her neck and in both of her lungs as well.
What is it like hearing your fiancé telling you that there's cancer throughout the top half of her body?
Horrible. Shattering. Can't really say anything else. Just shocking. Yeah. You know, makes you feel so sad. Someone so fit and young and, you know, just one of those people that matter and count. You know, in today's day with the family and all that sort of stuff, you know, absolutely shattered. Didn't know what to say, just wanted to suck it out of her, to be honest, and I'll take it. Mm-hmm. You know, that's my instant reaction was that.
That night would be one of the longest Verity and Aaron had ever experienced. In less than 6 months, their lives had been turned upside down, and now they were both travelling on the road to nowhere.
I was holding her for probably about 4 or 5 hours and didn't let go.
The race to save Verity's life had already begun, and doctors were scrambling to catch up.
They pretty much just said, look, we're going to have to throw chemotherapy at you straight away, the strongest that we've got. Otherwise, you won't last to Christmas.
But it wasn't only Aaron coming to terms with this devastating diagnosis. Verity's mother, Jeanette, also had to deal with the crushing realisation that her daughter had terminal cancer.
Verity was supposed to pick my nursing home. She was supposed to close my Facebook account and my email account and plan my funeral. And she's not going to do it. She won't be there.
Losing Verity is something that Aaron thinks about every single day. It's a thought that's as inescapable as the disease itself.
I think about when I'm looking at her on the couch, she slowly fades away and I never see her again.
You see that happen in front of you?
Yeah.
What does that feel like?
Yeah, shattering. Yeah, very shattering. And, you know, trying to explain to your kids about the same situation, you know. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I've had Austin, my oldest, you know, write out little love notes and letters to her and to try and cheer her up. And, yeah, that's pretty heart-wrenching.
Verity's last days also weigh heavily on her mum.
But in those final moments, have you thought about what you'd say to her? What would you like Verity to hear from you?
I have thought about it. It's very difficult. But Grandma and Granddad will look after you.
The future is unpredictable. But there's one thing in her life that is constant and never changing. The love that Aaron has for his soulmate.
I'm not going to leave her side, you know, not for anything. I'll never leave her.
It is absolutely a beautiful story, and they are just soulmates. And when we're putting that story together, Sarah, we just realised, just isn't that what everyone wants, that beautiful love story that they have? Well, this morning, we have got a few surprises to bring to this family and to Verity, and we're going to do it live on air right now. She has no idea that we're coming, so this might shock her a little bit, but we're going to do that as we come up here now. Now, Aaron has done an amazing job of keeping Verity away from outside and not watching the show, as I mentioned before. Now, we're going to come out. Beautiful car there, a Nissan. Love a Nissan. Now, if we come up here, it's going to knock on the door. Now, we understand that that Aaron has organised for Verity to answer the door. Let's just try this now. Oh, they're very secure, very secure. Just do the doorbell as well to see there if Verity might answer the door. Here we go. Just another little knock here. Verity, are you there? She's going to be coming out any moment now. Just, hello there. Is that Verity?
It is.
Hello, Verity. Can you come out here for a moment?
Sure. What is this?
Verity, how are you? Come out here for me. Okay. Hello, how are you? Come on out here. Now, my name is Robbo from Studio 10. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very good. A little bit shocked? Now, I'm going to tell you, you're live on air right now, so around the country, so no swearing. I know, I understand you're a bit of a swearer, aren't you?
Yeah.
All right, so we'll both try and keep it from not swearing.
Okay.
Now, tell me, Verity, this has been a pretty rough year for you, hasn't it?
Yeah, it hasn't been that good, no.
No, not at all. But, well, I understand, though, there is a pretty exciting event happening in a few weeks. What can you tell me?
I'm getting married.
You're getting married, are you? That is beautiful. Hello, Aaron, good to see you again, mate. Hello, Jeanette, how are you? Lovely to see you. Boys, how are you? Now, tell me, I've done my research. Now, if you've got a wedding, you need a honeymoon. Is that right?
Generally.
Yeah. Have you ever heard of the Great Barrier Reef?
Yeah.
You've heard of the Great Barrier Reef? Have you ever been there?
No, never.
Well, pretty soon you're going to be going there. Thanks to our very good friends at Hamilton Island at the Beach Club. We are going to be sending you for a honeymoon to that beautiful part of the world, to the Great Barrier Reef. What do you think? No, I'm not kidding. I wouldn't joke about that. Oh, we're going to send you there. We're going to send you there after your wedding to go for a beautiful honeymoon there. It is crystal blue waters. You're snorkeling, sunbaking, having cocktails by the pool, everything. That is where you're going to go.
That's amazing. Thank you.
Now, I've had a look around, Verity. I can't find a plane anywhere here. Do you have a plane anywhere?
No.
No, well, we're going to send you in style. Thanks to our very good friends at Virgin Australia. We are going to send you. Come over here. We're going to send you. Thanks to Virgin Australia. All the way up there, you and Aaron. And we're going to send you business class. What do you think about that?
Oh, God, I don't know. I don't know what to say.
It's pretty amazing. Now, Sandy, is she going to have the flight of her life?
She certainly is. We'll take care of both of them.
Absolutely, absolutely. What do you think about that? You're flying business class to Hamilton Island for your honeymoon.
That's amazing.
That is amazing.
That's insane. That's unreal.
You're pretty in shock at the moment? Well, we're going to keep shocking you now, just for the fun of it. Now, I understand, I've done my research as well, that you've got a bit of a bucket list. Is that right?
Yeah, I've got one. Yep.
All right, and on that is diving with great white sharks. Guess what you're going to do?
No, no way.
We're going to send you to go diving with great white sharks. Really? That's what we're going to do. So first we're going to send you to Hamilton Island, then we're going to send you down to Port Lincoln to swim with great white sharks, thanks to Calypso Star Tour Charters. Now, what do you think about that? That's pretty fun.
It's amazing.
Are you nervous about it?
Probably now that you said that I'm doing it, yeah.
Oh, yeah, you can all be all bravo and everything, but once you get there, you're going to have to jump in the cage with those sharks.
I'll do that.
It's going to be pretty amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
How do you feel, Aaron? What do you think about all of this?
Awesome. Overwhelming. Yeah, definitely. I'd like to thank Channel 10, Studio 10, Robbo yourself, Mr. Grant Davis there in the background, especially Virgin, Hamilton Island, and Calypso Shark Charters. Thank you very much.
So were you expecting us to knock on your door this morning? You weren't expecting that at all, were you? No, not at all. You were going to have...
You've been hiding at my house.
Well, we have been, actually. We've been staking out the whole morning there, feeling a bit creepy, but that's okay. That's all the surprises. We've also got some a bit of emotional scenes over here with the little fella there with...
That's Riley, the 3-year-old.
And there's Austin.
And my friend Michelle.
And Michelle, we're all here. We've all been staking out the whole morning. It's been pretty amazing, isn't it?
This is awesome. Thank you so much.
We're so glad that we could do it for you.
Thank you.
We're so glad, Verity. Thank you so much. And all the best to your family from all of us at Studio 10. Give me a big hug. Lovely to see you.
Thank you very much.
And also, Sarah, a massive thanks to all of our friends who have made this possible, the Beach Club on Hamilton Island, Virgin Australia. You can head to virginaustralia.com.au because those guys will take you anywhere in style and really the only airline you ever want to travel on. Is that right, Verity?
Pretty much, yeah.
Absolutely. I love Virgin Australia. Great to them. And also Calypso Star Charters for helping us bring one of those bucket list items ticked off Verity's list. From the Adelaide Hills, we will see you soon, Sarah.
Oh, David. Now, I know Aaron and Verity can't hear us, Robbo, but can you just give them another group hug from all of us on the couch? We're just sending so much love your way.
I've actually been told to give you another massive group hug from all of you.
All in.
That's from all of us at Studio 10. Oh, hey! How you going there, buddy? Oh, beautiful. You guys are going to have a fantastic time, and thank you.
What a beautiful family.
We wish them all the best.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.